Hey everyone, I am Jaden Hydara, aka SpideyFan101, and today I am here to talk about one of my absolute favorite movies of last year, that being Blue Beetle. Now, I meant to talk about this movie when I originally saw it, but I was coming off of a summer program where I was a peer mentor, and I immediately went to South Carolina afterwards to visit family, and then college started up again. All this to say, I've been busy. But now I'm finally here to talk about the movie. Now it's no secret that superhero films have been severely lacking in the public eye in general as of late. While I think there was some great superhero media last year, like Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, Shazam 2, What If Season 2, The Marvels, heck, I even enjoyed The Flash movie, more than I expected to, as well as Superman Lois Season 3. Final season of The Flash, there was some truly great superhero media last year. However, it was still lacking in a lot of ways, especially for the ones that I didn't mention. But one movie that I thought really persevered to not only be one of the greatest superhero movies of last year, and just one of the best movies of the year, and was much needed beacon of hope and light that was very much needed, is Blue Beetle. Blue Beetle not just has a superhero film, as a movie, brought back a level of happiness and investment and overall excitement within me that I haven't felt since I watched Power Rangers 2017 for the first time. And it was a film that follows in that film's legacy of really focusing on the characters, what makes them special, their bonds and motivations, and making it all have a truly satisfying and emotionally resonant payoff, as well as having Becky G in the movie. Thank you for that. Thank you for that, DC. I appreciate that. I love Becky G. For starters, Jaime Reyes is such an amazing character. Solo Maridueña. I hope I got that right. Right, good sir. Did an absolutely amazing job playing him, and he is for sure a definitive casting. He brings such a cool yet emotionally fun and dynamic side to Jaime. He's a post-college man trying to figure out his place in the world while trying to figure out how to help his family in the process. When he ends up finding the Scarab from a character who is the second MVP that I will talk about later, he ends up slowly but surely finding out what his purpose in life is, and that's to be a hero. And the film did an absolutely amazing job of making his journey so amazing and easily got me invested in it. Kajida was also amazing, once again being played by Becky G. I originally had no idea she was in the movie until I saw her name in the credits, but I love how she brought personality to Kaji. Most often than not, AI characters in movies can come off cold and soulless, but not Kaji. And not only did the writing service the character and all the characters in a major way, but it also serviced Kaji and her mini arc in the film. But that personality all stems from Becky G. And she was great, as she always is. And speaking of great female characters, Jenny Cord. Now, I'm new to Blue Beetle comics, so forgive me if I'm getting this wrong. But from everything I know and the research I've done, Jenny Cord is an OC made for this movie. And if that's the case, if I'm right about that, then Jenny is quite possibly my favorite OC, right next to Kahori from What If. Jenny is such an amazing character, and if it wasn't for Jaime, she would be my favorite character in the film. And no, it's not because Bruna Marquezine, I hope I got her name right, is an unbelievably beautiful woman. Even though, she most definitely is. That's as obvious as saying, hey, water is wet, you know what I'm saying? But It is because she is a wonderful actress, and not just in this movie, but in interviews and everything I've seen her in, I could just feel how much she puts her heart and soul into her performance, and how she carries herself, and it's wonderful and charming to see. And Jenny Cord is just such a dynamic character. We really feel for Jenny throughout the film, not only because she was basically orphaned because of Ted Cord's disappearance, but she was also shafted from Cord Industries, and left with years of trauma and loneliness. But when she discovers what the kind of main villain of the movie was doing with the OMAG machines, She takes the opportunity to do what's right and stop them before this technology can be released into the world and used for terrible means. And throughout the film, her journey finding new family in the Reyes family and her relationship with Jaime was so heartfelt, and I loved her journey in the film. Jenny was and is such an amazing character, and I love her very much. As for the Reyes family, I think they are really awesome, and they are definitely the emotional core of the film. George Lopez is a childhood icon for me. I watch his show every year. Every year since I was a kid to now. I love it. I always will. And I am a really big fan of his. To me, he's an absolute comedy legend, and he definitely brought his touch to this role. He was by far the best character among the cast of the Reyes family, and the most enjoyable. And another thing that George has always been great at is having those emotional undertones with his comedic deliveries. And here was one of the best examples of that. That Rudy, which is his character in the film, was a great character. Or Rudy or Cesar. And the rest of the family, Miragro, Nana, Alberto, were great as well. Especially Alberto. The scene towards the end where he's talking to Jaime and propelling him towards his destiny, even in death, was one of the best scenes in the movie. Now, the only thing that I didn't care for in the movie were the villains. Victoria Cord and Conrad Carpex. The reason why I say they were the weakest parts of the film is really just because there's not much to them. Carpex has a really nice ending when Jaime spares him and learns about his backstory. And Carpex has a change of heart and sacrifice himself. You know, that was all great. But everything beforehand just didn't work for me. And it just wasn't interesting in the first two-thirds of the film for me. As well as Victoria, she is just a generic, average, run-of-the-mill, eccentric billionaire villain that a lot of movies do, and unfortunately, this film did not do anything to make the character different. There could have been something interesting in regards to her seeing Jenny's true potential and how she could run Cord Industries in a better way than her, and she tries to stop her. Like the saying goes, the biggest haters are the ones that see the most potential in you. And there are some hints of that a little, but there wasn't really enough of that to make her interesting. But those were the only things that didn't work in the movie for me. Overall, Blue Beetle is a film that made me really happy, and that makes me really happy. Two irresistibly lovable main characters. A family that really brings more heart and soul to a film that already has a large abundance of that. Amazing writing and storytelling. Love for the characters and the source material they come from. And overall, an amazing standalone superhero film that will stand the test of time and be yet another example of how superheroes can thrive if you pair them with people who love and care about the characters and the stories they come from without having to make them teaser trailers or some puzzle/chess piece in a never-ending cash grab. So, and talk about getting me excited for James Gunn's DC. Like, this is what we're getting right out of the gate. Can you imagine how good Creature Commandos, Superman Legacy? Oh, man. But I'll get to James Gunn's DC in another video. Yeah, I can't wait to talk about that. So, yeah, I love this movie. And I love this movie. And I'm going to give it a 9.5 out of 10. It's definitely my favorite DC film right next to The Batman. And I just had to talk about it because I love this movie and everything it stands for. So yeah, I've never really looked into Jaime Reyes as a kid. I knew he existed, but I never looked into his comics or anything. But after this movie, I actually started reading his comics, starting with Graduation Day, and I love it so much. I'm starting to think that my big three of DC is starting to form. Because for Marvel, of course, and in general, my big three is Kamala Khan, Peter Parker in the Spider-Verse, and America Chavez. But for DC, for those that don't know, or for those that haven't seen my 2021 Jessica Cruz video, my favorite DC character, and just my fourth favorite character in general, is Jessica Cruz. That will always be the case. And she will always be there. James Gunn, Please give her a project. I beg you. After this movie, though, my second would be Jaime, and my third has always been a close battle between Zatanna, Superman, and Supergirl. I'll decide one day, but yeah, that's it. I love the movie, and it and everyone involved. Solo, who is definitely on my radar from now on. Bruna, who has officially become my new obsession. The OGs know what I'm talking about. She's become the new member of that club for me. And everyone from the director, writer, everyone involved have a special place in my heart. And with that, I am Jane Hydar, aka SpideyFan101, saying peace.